Tennessee lawmakers who voted to get rid, to expel black lawmakers for voicing their support for community, well, they can't believe that people are calling them racist. It's the most unbelievable thing in the world. Then the one representative who dissented to protect the white woman, well, what do you think he said about, what do you think they said about him? Here it is.
Please forgive me if my comments are not going to talk to Christ like you. I think now, more than ever, everyone should recognize that Democrats are not our friends. I listened for the last 3 days to Democrats, Sam McKenzie, Chisholm, Parkinson, trash us as racist. I've never had anybody call me a racist. And for the last 3 days, all I have heard from them is how this is the most racist place. One of these white supremacists. Good Lord, we have to realize they are not our friends. They can smile, and man, that doesn't mean I can't be polite to them, but they are not our friends. They destroy the Republic and the foundation of who we are. And Jody, I'm just going to say it here because you signed the letter. You straight up came to me and said you were 100% where I was. And you went on the House floor and you did the opposite. Man, you hung us out to dry.
I sat there and had my internal debate on what to do. Then the bell rings. I'm concerned that I'm going to vote yes. A resolution that I know is wrong.
I think the problem I'm having is if we don't stick together, if you don't believe we're at war for our republic, with all love and respect to you, you need a different job. The left wants Tennessee so bad because if they get us, the Southeast falls and it's game over for the republic. This is not a neighborhood social gathering. We are fighting for the republic of our country right now. I'm going to have to swallow this to see Mr. Jones back up here walking these hallowed halls that the greats of Tennessee stood in and watched them disrespect this state that I chose to move to. And by golly, it's got to stop. I'm sorry for getting angry here. My father was D-Day plus four, and he fought for this freaking country, and many of his friends died. You got to do what's right. Even if you think it might be wrong, you got to do what's right. And you got to protect this freaking republic here in Tennessee. Or you know what? I'll go to hell home.
All right. Well, when a white lawmaker says, by golly, obviously it's serious. So what do you have here? Let's put their pictures up full mass. Okay. So these two individuals on the recording, you have Tennessee Republicans, Jason Zachary and Scott Cepicky. They are the ones who are talking about they cannot be friends with Democrats anymore. They're just not their friends. See, these lawmakers voted to expel two young black lawmakers for breaking an office policy, disenfranchising the 78,000 individuals who voted for each of those lawmakers to represent them. They decided to be heavy-handed. They decided to do something they would have never done for a white colleague. And remember, the white female who did the exact same thing, survived the vote because of this guy. Put him up. You got lawmaker Jody Barrett, who defended himself while being rebuked in the audio for his recanting of the vote. Now, he was the dissent for the white female. And keep in mind, while these lawmakers are saying they have never been called racist, that's a lie. Maybe they have never been called racist out loud in the press, but I guarantee you people have called them racist before. The reality is, do you see how they talk? Did you hear that conversation? I disagree with their political ideology. But I want Democrats to be that sincere when they're talking among themselves behind closed doors. You see, those individuals, while wrong, they were authentic. They were sincere. They were passionate. Still wrong. Democrats are right, typically. Progressives are right. But when we get behind closed doors, when there's a left-leaning conversation and there's no camera, there's no microphone, who's in that room talking like that? Who can we depend on to be in that room talking in a way that truly opposes the status quo, that says this is more than just a vote? Republicans are saying that. They're saying that in front of the camera and behind it. Now, once again, they're wrong. The policies are wrong. the position is wrong completely, we actually have something to hang on to. The majority of Americans actually agree with progressive policies. That's a big deal. All right, Trey, thoughts here?
I'm from Tennessee. I've been tracking this the whole time in shame, mostly. It's been, you know, pretty upsetting for me. I want to quickly give a shout out, though, to my buddy Justin, who runs the Tennessee Holler, which is the progressive outlet which obtained and released that audio that we just played. You guys had your watermark on there, whatever. Justin goes down to the Statehouse in the Capitol all the time and, you know, asks these guys the tough questions, holds their feet to the fire, takes them to task, all that stuff, and has paid the price for it. He's had his house shot at, in fact, outside of Nashville. So it's like very real and very frightening back in Tennessee. I also, like these guys, like you said, the way they talk about it, they're definitely being authentic. That's like the scary part to me.
Right.
You can tell how genuine it is because they're, I mean, they talk about it like it's like a holy war or something, or, you know, or that a holy war is forthcoming, like the literal, you know, the fate of the Republic is at hand and they've got to join ranks and do, you know, and fight back. They genuinely believe they're not racist, which is crazy to me, but they do. I mean, it shouldn't be crazy to me. I've known plenty of people like that who are clearly racist, who truly don't think they are and are offended at the notion that they might be. And they also think that they rep. You just said the majority of Americans agree with us. I agree with you, and I know that statistics back that up. These people think that it's like 85% of Americans are on their side or whatever. Like, they truly think they represent, like, you know, the real America, which is under direct threat from the woke mind virus or whatever. And it's crazy. I mean, these are the zealots. The ones at the state level are like true believers, and they're terrifying. I will say, lastly, a lot of people that are very plugged in politically and stuff have been telling me that they think that these guys may have overplayed their hand a little bit in this whole scenario, and that it might end up coming back to bite them. So there's perhaps some optimism for it moving forward, because they've motivated a lot of young people in Tennessee, protested, taken to the streets, all this stuff. It's like, you know, it may be a bridge too far ultimately. So that's what I'm telling myself and what I'm hoping for right now.
Yep, I agree with you. When that kind of energy decides to be heavy-handed, as we have seen demonstrated, typically there is a response from the community. We will continue to follow.